Hey everyone, happy Monday and happy day one for my Pillars 3-day mini series on Instagram. So I'm going to do these on IGTV and see how it goes. I want to talk about the pillars of living a nourished and free life, and not just nourishing your body, but nourishing your mind and your soul as well, and truly living in freedom in all those areas of your life. So today I am going to talk about the nourishing your body component and nourishing as far as nutrition and food and your mindset towards food. So a lot of people, when they come to me, my one-on-one clients, they expect me to just give them a meal plan, tell them to eat more veggies, and send them on their way. But we do a lot of mindset work together in our one-on-one sessions together. So I wanted to go over a few of the tips and the tactics that I teach my clients when we're trying to change their mindset about food. Because I would argue that what you think about your food affects you more than the actual food you eat. And there's such a gut-brain connection surrounding what we eat, our emotions, our stress level, things like that, our food guilt. All of that impacts the way we react to certain foods and ultimately our health. And so my first tip with my clients is that no food is ever off track and no indulgence sets you off track that you have to start over tomorrow. And so that thought process is super damaging because it promotes an all or nothing mentality, which basically makes you feel like, okay, now I have to eat everything because tomorrow the diet starts. Tomorrow is day one again. And I hate that mentality because it just sets you up to fail. Whereas you can have a bowl of popcorn or a handful of goldfish crackers or some pretzels and peanut butter and say, this is part of nourishing my body, mind, and soul. And my next meal, I'm going to go right back to those nourishing, wholesome foods that I know feed my body well. So for example, I've been making a lot of gluten-free treats lately. I love baking gluten-free treats and regular treats. And one night I told myself, okay, I need to stop with these treats. They're too tempting. I need to just stop. And just that feeling, hi Emma, just that feeling made me feel like I needed to eat all of those treats that night so that tomorrow I could start day one. But then the minute I said, you know what? I can have a treat tonight. I can have a treat tomorrow. I didn't even want it anymore. And I didn't even end up eating it that night because it lost that power over me. So when we just incorporate all foods into our healthy eating lifestyle, we're never off track, so we never have to start over, and that's such a freeing and empowering mindset to be in when it comes to your nutrition. Secondly, I teach my clients addition nutrition. So that's basically what can we add to your day, add to your breakfast, add to your lunch. Ask any of my clients. One of the first things I do with them, I add food to their day. So if they're having cereal in the morning, I say, great, add a hard-boiled egg, add a breakfast sausage, add a green smoothie. If they're just having a sandwich at lunch, I say, cool, add a big green salad with some almonds and cashews and a really yummy dressing or some avocado. I always add nourishing, mom life, right? I always add nourishing and healthy food to my clients' plates so that they never feel deprived. We're not giving them a list of no foods. They're actually getting a list of yes foods to start adding into their day. It's all about flipping that mindset from scarcity to abundance. And lastly, what I always preach is no matter how clean your diet is, if it's stressing you out, it is not healthy for you. So you could be following, you could be following 100% organic diet, no processed foods, no sugar, but if it's stressing you out and if you're living in a state of anxiety of you don't know what you're gonna eat, you're going to a certain party and you don't know what they're cooking and you're just frantic about your eating situation, the stress that that mindset is causing is worse for your health than just a little bit of sugar or that slice of bread or that slice of pizza. So a lot of times we have to view health holistically. How is it affecting your everyday life? If you're at your perfect weight, right? Your weight, you're thin, you're feeling good, but you are miserable and you're anxious around food and you're constantly obsessed over whether or not you ate too much or you ate too little, or if your body's healthy, or if that one piece of processed food is gonna ruin your health or you're gonna break out because of that one slice of pizza or whatever it is, that is not a healthy place to be, my friend. And I know from experience, I could be following the picture perfect diet, but if my mindset is in the gutter and I'm just living in food guilt and food shame and constant worry about my food, that is not healthy. And so this is where the mindset comes in, and how we think about the food we eat makes more of an impact on our health than just the food on our plate. It's not just about the food. It starts with food. I fully believe that there are foods that are just so nourishing and healthy for us, and we should fill up our plates with those foods most of the time. But that leaves room for the treats and the sweets now and then, that we don't get derailed from them. We don't fall off the wagon, because there is no wagon. It's your life. You can never fall off the wagon if you're just living a lifestyle that chips and salsa are included in my nourished and free lifestyle. Gluten-free treats are included in my nourished and free lifestyle. Chinese food is included in my nourishment free lifestyle. That's just part of my life. So they lose their power over me. I'm not stressed out about what I'm eating. And I'm always focusing on all the nourishing foods that I get to add to my plate, so that when the treats come and go, they don't knock me off track. They don't send me to a spiral of binge eating, because I don't go off track anymore. Every food is part of my life. And so that's today's lesson. Tomorrow I'm going to be talking about fitness and movement and how that feeds into a nourishment free lifestyle. So I hope you guys stay tuned for that, and I will chat with you later.